Hello everyone. I'm coming from Chinese Academic Science. I'm the second member of this paper. The first one, I cannot come here to make a presentation. So the paper title is also provides a story comprehension with hierarchical encoder decoder. Here is the outline of this talk. First, I will give some introduction about what is the story comprehension task, and second, I will mention some little work about this task and the problem in this recurrence method. And the third, we will give our model, it's an encoding decoder framework for story comprehension. And finally, I will give out the experiment result and the conclusion. So let's see, first see what is the story comprehension task. In this talk, we have a story, it's counted five sentences, and this story is made up of the five highly recapitulated sentences. And the first four sentences will be regarded at the input and given at the context, and the task is to predict what is the character sentences in the following. In this task, besides the character sentences, some human label negative sentences is also provided. So our task is to judge which candidate is the correct answer according to the provided context. The difficulty in this task is that traditional methods always regarded it as a classification problem. So, for this method, heavily relied on discriminative learning. However, the bounded story unlabeled, it contains only positive sentences. So, many stories cannot provide negative text sentences. So, the absence of the negative example makes this task very difficult, so it makes the discriminative learning impossible. So, many methods convert to some supervised technical route. For example, the first kind of is discriminative learning. This method always regarded as event chains in the user stories. So they captured a rich set of the causal of temporal relation between the daily events. So they make many efforts on how to extract the event from the given sentences. They always transform these sentences into some factory triplets based on such as static parsing trees. So the method can compute the relevance of similarity between these factory triplets. So they can judge which is the correct answer from the candidates. And the second type of this progress method is they employ the language model. They coordinate the candidate with providing four sentences together. They can use some supervised language model to model the circuits, and then they can compute the complexity of the whole paragraph or documents. The candidate with small complexity will be regarded as correct answer. And the third type of method is sentence similarity. They just use some classical similarity models to compute the similarity between the provided four sentences and the candidate. And the candidate is a big similarity, a big score will be regarded as the correct answer. So the disadvantage of the current method is that for learning, they always have it on some LP tools. So we need to extract some triplets from the sentences. So this method is always virtual and hard to generalization, because if you for other languages or other domains, we have no enough tools to extract such extraction. And for language model-based method, we do not take the document account, such as the discourse into account. Sometimes they are biased toward the specific target. And for the third kind of method, sentence similarity, they always ignore the neutral interaction between the context and the target. So the contribution of this work, we have the four contributions. We propose supervised, just employing the positive example. We have no negative example, a neural model, true for storing reading comprehension. Our model is under the encoder and decoder architecture. And we also encode the context with the hierarchical model to take the document structure into account. Then we design a self-controlled loss of weight structure for training our model. And then finally, we employ the abundant external data for pre-training. So here is the architecture of our models. We also regarded these tasks as the reading, motion reading, comprehension tasks. Our model is based on a 6-to-6 model. Our model has two parts. The first part is encoded. We encode the semantic of the whole input for sentences. And we just use a hierarchical STM model to learn the semantic repetition of the given four sentences. And the second part is the decoder. We just do the decoder to generate the correct sentences directly. If we constrain the generation result equals to each candidate, we can compute the output of the candidate. So we can use, we can comprise the output probability of each candidate, and then we can select the correct answer. So in the encoder, in an encoder way, just deploying a hierarchical encoder to learn the semantic computation of the given four sentences. We use the bidirectional STM to learn the semantic encoder for each sentence, and also use the unidirectional STM to learn the document encoder or context, the document semantic representation or context representation of the four sentences. And in the decoder, we just based on the learned the semantic representation of the from the encoder, we just need to output the sentences within the decoder. The decoder has been widely used for other LP related tasks, for example, with the translation, dialogue system. Well, we also use the attention mechanism in the decoder. There has no difference from the previous method. So for the first way, we just to computing the probability of the given target sentences, we just to compute the conditional probability of the output sentences by giving the context. It's just a measure of the output probability of each word in the output sentences. So for training our model, we just use the maximum likelihood estimation training objective as our loss function. We just to maximize the conditional probability of the output sentences by giving the context. It's just in this function, we treat each token in the output sentences with equivalent of weight. However, in the standard encoder decoder architecture, the information of each time starts in the decoder is not equivalent. For example, in the early output words in the output sentences, we have low confidence because of just one word of output, so we have lower confidence about this word. But when more word was generated, we have the more confidence, so we have the more confidence for the output probability for that word for later words. So it means that we must dynamically turn each word weight in the final object function. And we also can use some simple rules to alter the weight for each word of the function. It means that for the early generated word, we have the low weight, and for the later output word, we have the low weight. So we also, in our model, we just learn this with my models, model itself, we construct a network to learn the ways for each word in the output sentences. And I put these ways on our loss function, where Ni is the loss of the sentences, and beta ij means learn ways. So we also, in our models, listen work in your natural language processing, you go to natural processing of the pre-training, such as Verge, XLNet, and GPT-2. And we in our model also want to pre-train make such a pre-training process in our model. So we collect more data from more larger corpus. We have two resources. The first is book corpus, and the second is Bingning. We just use our encoder decoder architecture to pre-train our network based on these two resources, because we can randomly sample five sentences from these resources. Okay, let's see the experiment result. We test our our model on open access data size named story closed test. In this test, we have three parts. The first part is the tree data. In this part, we only have we have the 100,000 data stories. But in this story, we only have the positive examples. We have no any negative targets. And the second is developer data set. In this data set, we have 1,871 human labeled negative targets in this part. In the third part is the test data. It also has 1,871 human labeled negative target. So our model is only training on the training data and test data and the data design. Here is the result, and the right column is the supervised state of art method on these tasks. Because in our training data, there's no any negative examples provided, so in the supervised method, they only train on the developer data set. From the result, we can see if we have some human provided negative examples, the supervised method obtains a better performance. And the left column is the supervised method, and HLSTM is our models. So we also HLSTM without attention is our basic model, and HLSTM is our basic model plus attention mechanism, and LSTM plus LR means our model is trained under the most weighted loss function. And HLSTM plus LR plus PT means that our model has was the training on some pre-training process, and then trained on the training data side. And the other side is a supervised method for this task. From the result, we can see our method can get the best performance. Although we have no negative example provided, our method ICTIR plus LR plus PET have the close performance to the supervised still art. So our model deploying the encoder decoder architecture, so we directly to generate the correct sentences. So our model can be regarded as a generative model. So we can also build a discriminant model by randomly sample sentences with negative targets and train a classifier based on it. From the result, we can see a discriminant. Although we provide some negative example by randomly sampling, the discriminant model cannot obtain the better performance because the random sample, something that you tell is maybe not correct, make the model not so much descriptive. So our model is just to train on the trained model with known adding negative targets, but it can obtain a better performance. Here is the result of the loss reweight function. We have the ME loss, where our model are trained under the ME loss function. We can use some rules to reweight loss function. And we also use some proposed model to learn the ways in the reweight loss function. From this result, we also can see that the proposed model can dynamically learn the which is the correct or the best ways for the final loss function. You have gotten the better performance. Finally, is the result of the pre-training. We just skip sort means that we don't have the pre-training process, and we also use some tricks such as pre-training in the training process. We also use the single resources to make the pre-training. Finally, the result is that we use the two resources to make pre-training and plus pre-training. From the result, we can see both corpus can provide some stories with close to the our data site. Wikipedia has a much domain, much text from many domains, so they are more far to our data site compared to the corpus. Book corpus. From that we can see if we only use the book corpus, we can get better performance than we use only Wikipedia data set for training. Okay, here is the solutions. In this paper, we propose a supervised hierarchical encoder decoder architecture for story reading comprehension. We design a self-reweight training structure to optimize the decoder, and we deploy a pre-training model for training the models. And the experiment results show that our unsupervised model could achieve a comparative result with the supervised models. Okay, that's all. Thank you.